Guys, I have been waiting for this game ever since it launched in Japan, like it's probably been about a year now. And so I'm super hyped that this is finally coming to the global servers. Hi, welcome to a Blue Archive video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be talking about this fantastic game. In this video, I want to talk about like the pre-registrations, but also a little bit about my experience on the JP server. Because for me personally, I played on the JP server at launch. I did like the whole arena race. I did like the whole re-rolling. I've got a pretty good idea as to like how it all feels, the music, the gameplay, and all of that. And so I did want to share my JP experience with you guys so that you guys can either get hyped or kind of be like, nah, this one's not for me. And so what exactly prompted this video was this guy over here. As you can see, Blue Archive pre-registration is up. And so if you go over to like the respective stores, both Google and Apple, you will see that the app is there available for pre-order. However, on top of that, if you come over to the website, you will be able to pre-register as well. So if you guys can see this over here, it says go to pre-registration over here. Sorry, my thing is a little bit blocked. Look at that. And so if I do click on this button, it will take me over to the pre-registration form, which is pretty standard. It's asking for like your email address as well as your OS. And there's not overly much to this. It's just like your standard pre-registration where if we get like 500k pre-registers, we'll get a whole bunch of gifts. And so these are the gifts that we will be getting. So we're going to be getting a whole bunch of money and some gemmies. And on top of that, we will be getting a 2-star unit if we hit 500k pre-registrations, 2-star Mutsuki. And so to be honest, 500k is a pretty ambitious goal. However, I do think it is pretty realistic. But that being said, the pre-registration rewards for JP was a little bit different. So we got a different character, which was pretty essential to pushing the story. But if I could kind of go into my experience and talk about this game, I would just want to really say like, this is pretty much pre-con if it was made in 2021. It's essentially identical, except you've got like 3D chibis instead. And so this image over here perfectly summarizes all of it. So you've got your team over here and you're moving from the bottom left-hand corner to the top right-hand corner. Here you've got your 3 different characters. I know that there are 4. I think one of them may be a support, but essentially what you can do is you can click on these to use your skills. So you do have like a mana gauge or like a cost gauge over here, and this just refills over time. So as you can see, we are up to 4 and we are refilling the 5th cost. And so naturally, using one of these skills is going to decrease your costs, and then it's just going to recharge over, and then you're just going to be able to use skills and stuff. But what I really wanted to show you guys is like this system over here. So you are moving from bottom left to top right again, but it is all automatic. And this is very, very similar to pre-con, right? Because a lot of it is auto, like you can't really change their attack chains or anything. The only thing you can do is like throw off bombs or throw grenades or like put up bunkers, stuff like that, right? And so that's why, like in my opinion, at a gameplay level, I would describe it as pre-con made in 2021 with 3D chubby chibis. Because if I show you guys a couple of the chibis, like let's have a look at this one over here, you'll notice that they are essentially like miniature chubby chibis. They're all like squashed and really cute. And that's essentially like the characters that will be deployed to the field. They're going to be these chubby chibis, and then they're going to go maul some chicks with guns, I guess. And so yeah, that kind of wraps up the gameplay aspect of it and what you can expect from it. From an arena point of view, it's pretty much virtually identical to what you're seeing here. And the arena system works like pretty much exactly the same as pre-con as well. You're going to be climbing ranks, and if you're able to maintain ranks, then you're going to be getting gemmies. And on top of that, you will get the first time rank bonuses. Again, very, very similar to pre-con. Anyway, with all of that being said, I do want to wrap this part up because like I don't have too much to show you guys, like live footage or anything. But the one thing that really, really stands out to me in this game is the music. It's actually insane. I think out of all gacha games, this game probably takes the cake for me personally for having the best music. Some other contenders are like Dragalia Lost, but like this and Dragalia are probably in a tier of their own. And so that's actually a really nice segue into this guy over here, which is the animation PV. And so I'm not going to play this because I'm going to get my ass DMCA'd as usual, but like this is pretty much a fully animated promotional video. But on top of that, they actually recorded an English cover or an English version of this song. And so guys, as always, I will drop the link to this promotional video down in the description below. And I think it's a great watch because it kind of gives you like the vibe, the music, the environment, like the sense of what you should be expecting from this game. TLDR, it's light and fluffy, and it's a whole bunch of cute waifus with guns. And so yeah, check it out. And so let me move on to the next part, which is the characters themselves. And so as you can see, the setting is kind of like high school or like a lot of high schools. So if I scroll back up one, I believe we can see the list of all of the different factions, I guess. These factions, I don't know if they actually contribute to anything. I didn't really get that far, but essentially they're kind of like your themes, right? So like, I think this is like your main school with like your main girls and stuff. And so as you can see, you got Shiroko over here, and then if we move across a little bit, we're gonna get over to the Gehenna girls. And so I see Hina, I see Aru. So this one is Hina over here, and then Aru is this one over here. And so on the JP launch, these were the reroll targets. This may be out of date information because I have not been following Blue Archive, but essentially Aru and Hina both, they were like extremely dominant, and even in PvP as well. I would say that between the two, although I like Aru more, I think Hina is way more prevalent and probably stronger, a cut above her. But again, this was just my experience on JP launch. The meta may have drastically changed, but for me personally, like with these characters, I just steamrolled the entire game. And so just scrolling through real quick, I just want to like show you guys the kind of the art style, what you can expect. So I think what you're going to notice is that there is a little bit of loot. And so just building on that topic, there is also live 2D. And so if you guys are like really into this kind of stuff, I guess pick this game up. But otherwise, the next thing that I want to talk about is kind of like the end game of this game. And so I think when a lot of people got to end game, that was probably the turning point of whether they kept playing or not. And the reason is because, well, to my knowledge, is that the end game is essentially you've got arena for PvP and then you've got raids. And unfortunately for raids, I believe they actually made it so that you needed to pull like specific characters to do extra damage to them. Me personally, I wasn't a massive fan of that. And honestly, I don't even know if that was like 100% true. Because to be honest, guys, when the raids finally came out, I couldn't really read any of it. And by that time, I was already kind of like going casual, like looking to drop it, wait for EN, aka this one right here. And so I don't know if they have added extra content. If you guys are JP players and you guys do have visibility over this kind of stuff, then do let us know down in the comments, what does the end game look like? Like, what can we expect to kind of do? For me personally, what I'm looking for is kind of just like a cute little waifu simulator, just like collecting kind of thing, you know? And as long as it does that for me, you know what? I think I'm in. All right, and so the next thing I want to talk about, which is probably the last thing, is about these guys down here. So Nexon, I don't know if this button's gonna work, but yeah, these guys, Nexon. So hopefully you guys are familiar with Nexon. They made like massive games, well, back in the day anyway, such as like Maple Story. They did Kart Rider. They've done a whole bunch of like those popular Korean games. And on top of that, they've also published a lot of phone games as well. And so what has happened, and I've kind of explained this in my Konosuba video, because Nexon is also publishing that one. What's happened is that I guess the reputation of Nexon has kind of been dragged through the mud. And so when a lot of people see Nexon, they're like, nah, I'm completely out. And so to that, I want to say, I think if you are willing to give the game a shot, you should still give it a shot. And to be honest, guys, I was quite the skeptic as well, but like there is a reason that I would say that. And that is because of this game over here. And so as you guys can see, this is Konosuba Fantastic Days. You can see that it is also being published by Nexon. And for me, I actually played this game for a few weeks. It was really good. It's just that like, I just did not have enough time. But the way that they've handled this game, it actually gives me a lot of faith in like Blue Archive. I think that Konosuba Fantastic Days was a positive case study for Nexon. And to be honest, it's probably boosted their reputation quite a fair bit. And so yeah, if you're one of the people that are on the fence because you see Nexon and you're like, oh man, nah, I'm not touching that one, I would say at least give it a shot because of how they've handled Konosuba. All right. And so I think that's pretty much it for like all the content that I wanted to cover about Blue Archive today. And so I want to leave you guys with a secret question, and that is, well, are you guys hyped for this game, Blue Archive? Me personally, I've been waiting for it since I played on JP and was like, well, this is awesome, but like, I want the global version. I've been waiting for a long time, so I'm really keen to see how they're gonna handle the global version. And hopefully, if it is good, I may stick around for it. However, that is enough about me. And so you guys let me know how you guys are feeling about this game. And if you would be so kind to drop that into the comments below, I would really appreciate it because it means you've watched up until the end of the video. And so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a like, a sub, a follow. And if you would like to support the channel, we do have a couple of different ways in the description below. We've got like a membership thing and some affiliate links. But otherwise, as Hoshino once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.